The rise of Pictish culture escalated after the Romans were forced to give up their quest for domination of Britain's unruly north. Perhaps many years of struggle in the hills and glens against the southern invaders had united the Pictish guerrilla fighters and eventually resulted in the mustering behind a single overlord. What we know about the Picts today derives mainly from the legacy they have left to us. The many intricately carved stones which bear the symbols of their lives and their beliefs. They made beautiful jewelry and musical instruments, as well as fearsome weapons. They lived together in family roundhouses. At the day's end, they cooked over open fires and told stories in music and song. But our Pictish ancestors also lived in turbulent times. When hostile tribes and invading armies threatened to destroy their kingdom, and when the control of land and territories meant the difference between survival or death. Their most famous victory was at Dunachan, or Nechtan's Mere, as the Northumbrians knew it, when the Northumbrian king, Egfrith, brought an army north from the Lothians in 685 AD and were routed by a Pictish force led by King Brethi. The young man grew up to become expert in hand-to-hand combat. They fought using swords they forged in their own fires, short spears and oval shields. They used their intimate knowledge of the land to their advantage, showing no mercy to the vanquished. With the coming of Christianity to mainland Scotland from the 6th century onwards, the images of the Picts recorded in stone tell us of their new faith and of its stories. We can only guess at how their lives were changed by conversion to Christianity, but there certainly seems to have been no softening of their warlike ways. What we do know is that in Pictish culture, inheritance and royal succession was matrilinear. It came through the female line. Kings inherited the right to rule through their mother's side of the family, and lives lived in harmony with the elements and tied to the seasons. Pictish men and boys fished, hunted wild boar and red deer, carved their symbols and experiences in stone, and fought for territory. But it was women and female children who were held in highest regard in Pictish society. The Picts were fierce in defending their lands and their communities. But there is evidence that they were also skilled hunters, metalworkers, stonemasons, potters, weavers, storytellers, and musicians. Forged their own weapons and domestic tools, wove their garments, grew simple crops, harvested wild berries, built boats, fished the rivers, and hunted deer and wild boar. For the Picts, the survival of the family was at the very core of existence, as important as the clear water in loch and river, the stories and the stones they carved, the flame at the heart of the fire, and the daily journey of the sun.